time. Once was not enough, you see. Hurt me one more time. People think I'm so strong, but if they only knew just how weak that I am when it comes to you. Hurt me one more time.
Hi, and welcome to Mode of Cosmic Therapy. We are delighted to have you back today. I'm delighted to be here. And Bridget is not with us again. She missed two shows in a row, but she had some things that she just had to take care of and couldn't be here. But we have her beautiful sister, who is the camera girl on camera number 3. And she is out from behind the camera and in front of the camera this week. Hello, Brandi. Brandi Noel Pyle. Hi.
Hi.
How are you doing?
Good.
How's it feel to be up here on in front of the camera instead of behind it?
Good.
Great. Well, we're delighted to have Brandi today. And just like we were delighted to have Mitzi last week. And Bridget will be back with us in the next upcoming season. Well, Brandi, this is going to be an adventure, isn't it? We don't know what we're going to do. We don't know what we're going to say. We don't know what's going to happen. That's sort of like life. And for all of those who are new, we thank the ones, we really do appreciate the ones that watch every single week. And we thank and appreciate all the new viewers today. Don't we, Brandi? And we welcome you to just have a ball with us in the next hour. What Mode of Cosmic Therapy is based upon is how everything in life is connected. And we will follow no pattern except the pattern of randomness and spontaneity, and that is what life is consisting of. In the next hour, we will pull papers out of a can, pull sticks, use books, draw, and whatever else might occur. And for those of you who do enjoy watching the show or are curious about it, more curious, please go up on the net and Google Paula Andrea Pyle, M-A, or Mode of Cosmic Therapy, and you'll see that I have a whole bunch of articles up there. I've got paintings and I've got music, original music that I've written and that I'm singing, because in my life, as I've said, every single week, I have done a lot of things. I've had 6 children and 11 grandchildren, and I have had a ball. I've been married 40 years to the same man, huh? It's wonderful. It's wonderful, and I've had a ball. So I've done a lot of things because I enjoy life, and that's what Mode of Cosmic Therapy is about. Okay, Brandi, have I said enough? Okay, let's get started with it. What we usually do every single, I'm not going to use this finger this week. You know, last week I kept pointing at Mitzi, so I'm going to hold it down this week, okay? If it pops out, it's not my fault, okay? Let's do pinky promise. Like me and Mitzi did, pinky promise. All right, I think you're supposed to do that when you say the same word. Is that right?
No, when you like swear to do something.
Okay, let's swear to do something. Okay, just because they say it's bad to swear, huh? So we just did that, didn't we? Okay, you're gonna pull a paper out of that box and look here. You know what? Oh, Willie Nelson's sitting up here. You know why? Because we got another car, but it wasn't a Bentley, but it's nice. It's a nice doggone car. We got a new car. And they had a tape player in it. You ever heard tell of that? A new car and they got a tape player in it. You know, it's got a CD player too. And so I put some Willie in there and I wanted to play it to hear. I love Willie. You love Willie? I do love Willie. But I'm going to listen to him on the way back home. Okay, we're going to pull this paper. We're going to see what it says. Last week, 2 of them fell out on Mitzi. But we're going to see what it says, and we're going to take this show, and it's going to form itself around whatever Brandi reads. Okay, Brandi, let's go with it.
Your heart is divided between memories of yesterday and visions of tomorrow.
Wow. Good gracious, that's a new one. That is a new one, sweetie. Read that again.
Your
heart. Read it slower so I can get some of that down.
Your heart is divided.
Heart is divided.
Between memories of.
Memories of.
Yesterday.
Mm-hmm.
And visions of tomorrow.
Okay. Your heart is divided between memories of yesterday and visions of tomorrow. Well, if your heart is divided between memories of yesterday and visions of tomorrow, then where are you at today? Where is room for the present, for being right here, being where your feet are? You know, there's an article up on the internet, be where your feet are. So, but if you are divided and living in the memories of yesterday or the visions of tomorrow, you're kind of like squeezing out this life. You're not showing up for it. So right now, what are you doing, Brandi?
Sitting in a chair.
Okay, and where are you?
Raleigh.
Okay, and what you got on?
Shirt and jeans.
Okay, and what grade are you in?
Ninth.
All right, so these are some of the aspects of your beautiful life. You are so beautiful, incredibly beautiful, just like your sister. And Mitzi is beautiful as well. Everybody's beautiful. But I'm saying that, honey, be here, honey. Be here, be here. Be where your life is. Don't miss one single solitary moment of it. Be here. Be in it. Feel it. Experience it. You know, last week I drew that picture of gluttony, you know, because gluttony is supposed to be such a bad thing. But we are pleasure-seeking creatures. And if all the time we're saying and trying to deny what we are, we're miserable. But if we come to terms with that, then it would eliminate all those things that we're thinking, we should do this, and we should do that, and we should do the other. Because they are divided memories. We're always saying, oh, well, I did that bad yesterday, so I shouldn't do that today, or I'll do better tomorrow. Forget that junk. Be here right now, and life will unfold as naturally and as beautiful as these roses. How you like my picture this week?
It's pretty.
Okay, what's the name of it?
Silence.
I like that name. If I could hear from any of you viewers out there, I guess you would have a title, you could give it to it too. That's beautiful. That's beautiful. That is honestly beautiful. That's what the name of that picture is going to be. Silence. Okay, Brandi, which one do first? It's your call.
The sticks.
You want to do the sticks. Okay, when we do the sticks, now, well, go ahead and do the sticks and then we'll see what we're going to do.
35.
Okay, do you want to do this book, the art book, any book on the table? What you want to do?
The art book.
You want to do the art book, okay? And you want number 35. Ah. Okay. This book, Cosmic Therapy Through Art. It's a book, one of the books I've written. That's what we use. This one of the books. A lot of these books up here I haven't written, of course, but this particular one happens to be, and it's coming all to pieces. Let me see. 35, baby. Well, I got to come on up here. I'm only on 13. 35! Look at there. There it is. Here's the picture, of course. You see the picture? It's a blazing fire. We talked last week, me and Mitzi did, about passion and how we didn't say call it a fire, but that's what passion is. It's a fire. Okay, wait a minute. Let me get my pencil because I love to write. Okay, baby, what we got?
Indifference in the true honor.
Okay, indifference is true honor.
Is true honor.
Okay, indifference is true honor. Indifference is true honor? Brandi, indifference. That means you don't care one way or the other. You can't determine what's good and what's bad. You've gone beyond that because good and bad are good and bad in different situations. Something's bad can be good in a certain situation, and something good can be bad in a certain situation. Because if you're a farmer and you need rain for your crops, that's good. But if I'm standing out there and it's pouring down and I'm getting wet, then it's bad for me. See? So indifference, going beyond what you think is good or bad, or going beyond any kind of idea of, we're going back to last week, but I'm not going to like you because you'll like me back. Or I'm not going to love you because of what you make me feel. I'm indifferent to all those things. So it must sound like that God may be indifferent. You know? We don't know, huh? He, she, it's got to be beyond a concept of good and bad, because all of it is part of it. I love that. Indifference is true honor.
Learn to remember to be totally indifferent to the results of your personal efforts, whether it to be in areas of money-making, friendship, family, personal relationships, career, and or fame and fortune.
All right, stop right there. Learn to be indifferent. Learn to be indifferent. Different. Indifferent. This means it does not matter. You don't care. You are not vested in the outcome. No lust of result. Whatever the result is of the enterprise is correct. Okay? It could not have been a different way. The divorce could not have been saved or done away with. The separation, whatever comes about, it comes about because that's the only thing that can happen. Nothing else can happen except what is happening. Nothing. Ever, 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 ever. If whatever happens is the right thing. Okay. And you can't be tied to the outcome. Okay, I'm going to do this if I get that. You're going to do that because you want to do it. And sometimes you have to do things you don't want to do. You know, you do sometimes, like washing dishes. But guess what? The plates get clean, right? Or you can eat on dirty plates if you want to. It's up to you.
Be not moved, neither be dismayed by the ups and downs involved with its journey.
Okay, be not moved nor dismayed by the ups and downs of the journey. Okay, Mitzi, am I laying this tablet on the microphone? You know, sometimes I watch the shows and it sounds terrible. So, but I'm trying not to. Okay, she says I'm not. Okay, great. What, baby? Be not dismayed, you said, and moved by whatever the outcome is. All right?
The events are totally impersonal, having nothing who's ever to do with it.
Okay. Your input. The results? Did you say results?
I said the events.
The events. See? That's different from the results. The events are totally impersonal. Totally impersonal. All right? So you're going to go through them. And whatever happens is not happening to you. It's not happening to you. You and whatever's going on is one and the same. There's no division between, what'd you tell me? Memories of yesterday and visions of tomorrow. The event is occurring right this minute. Okay? Did you get that? I'm not going to ask you to say it back. Because you told me before we went on the show, don't tell that to you. Dad says I tell it all. Go ahead, honey.
Simply enjoy the experience without comment or display.
Okay. Simply enjoy the event without comment
experience.
Or the experience. Simply enjoy the experience without comment or what?
Display.
Display. Okay. I hear you.
Be ever mindful to observe yourself in reacting to any circumstance, most especially when it involves flattering or admiration.
Admiration. Brandi, you are so beautiful. You are so beautiful, darling. You are so utterly beautiful, it stops time. See? Now what happened? What did it say? Be observant of your reactions, especially in those times when somebody's flattering you or trying to admire you. Be not moved, honey, because they are enjoying saying that. You get that difference, honey? They are enjoying saying it. That's enough, you know? And so it can't, because if you started saying, wow, she thinks I'm pretty, well, then immediately you're gonna start to like that person, okay? Well, when you start to like that person, then you're gonna start to feel obligated to that person, because you want her to keep saying you're pretty. So you would start doing things that were not natural, like wanting to call her up and say she's pretty. You hear me? And if at the beginning of the show when I was saying, because you are beautiful, there's no doubt about that, and I don't have to say it, it's just a fact, and Bridget's beautiful, and Mitzi's. Did you hear? We all say and do things that come from our natural selves. But when people say those things to you, honey, you remain, as the, what that says, indifferent to it. Okay?
Govern your need to be right, appreciated, recognized, or praised.
Govern those needs. Okay? Govern means watch out for your needs to be what?
Right, appreciated.
Right. Wait a minute. We got to go one at a time. Govern your need to be right. Okay? Let's say I said it was cold in this building, and you said it's not. I say it's cold. I say it's cold. You say it's not. All right? You are experiencing that it's not. I'm experiencing that it is. For you, you're right. For me, it's right. So neither one of us, I can't make myself, you feel that it's cold, and you can't make me feel that it's not. So govern your need in the sense of trying to be right in a situation. It's unimportant because you're experiencing what you're experiencing, and I'm experiencing what I'm experiencing. And so the need to be right comes from a place that is false. Okay? So don't have to be right. Be wrong a million times. It doesn't matter because it doesn't alter a doggone thing. Okay, next, govern your right, need to be right. What else?
Recognized.
Recognized. That means if you're in a party somewhere and you're having a good time and you are having the best time that you could possibly have, and you will because you're a teenager, okay, and somebody over in the corner isn't speaking to you or anything or isn't having anything to do with you, what has that got to do with you? If you're having all the fun that you can have right now, you won't even be you won't even be aware of that person, right? Okay.
Appreciated.
Appreciated. Oh, that's a big one. Appreciated. Govern your need to be appreciated. How would you know you were appreciated or not appreciated unless you were projecting the idea, I had a T in it, didn't I? Idea that you weren't having and doing everything you could do at the moment. If you were not comparing it to something you had before or something you wanted. See? That's where appreciation comes in. You still are not here. You're not here in this place. Because when you're here, right here, you couldn't be more appreciated.